جديد الليل أرخى علينا السدولا
السدولا
دعونا نناجي مولا جليلا جديد الليل أرخى علينا السدولا
لك الحمد والمجد والكبرياء
الحمد لله الحمد لله على حلمه بعد علمه وعلى عفوه بعد قدرته والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم النبي أولى بالمؤمنين من أنفسهم وأزواجه أمهاتهم صدق الله العظيم. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program, The Mothers of Islam. In our previous programs, we had looked upon the life, the virtue, the peculiarities, the exceptional qualities of Hazrat Khadija bint Khuwaylid and Sauda bint Zam'ah. Then in our last two programs, we had looked upon the life of the beloved of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hazrat Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha. And undoubtedly, amongst the wives towards the latter portion of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's life, Hazrat Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha had a very special position. Mention is made in the books of ahadith, in the books of narration, that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after the death of Hazrat Khadija radiyallahu ta'ala anha, saw Hazrat Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha in a dream that Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam came in and was shown Aisha radiyallahu ta'ala anha in a silken cloth and was told that this is your wife both in this world and in the year after. Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba relates a tradition from our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Aisha zawjati fil jannah. Aisha will be your wife in paradise. And of course, we in our last program, we looked upon various aspects of her life, the initial stages, and in particular, what qualities she brought into the marriage and from the marriage to how she benefited the ummah because of her exceptional talent, keen intellect, wisdom, and knowledge. And one of the reasons why Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam got married to her when she was young, comparative to all other wives of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam married when they were in advanced age, middle age, etc. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala was got married and came in the household of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam at a very young age. What was that age? What was the reason with regard to it? Is something that we had elaborated upon in some detail in our last program. One aspect that because of her keen intellect, being young, she could grasp. And we had made mention in our last program that she ranks as the fourth highest transmitter of the traditions and sayings of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the greatest narrator and transmitter of sayings of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, who narrated 5,374. Then Abdullah ibn Umar, 2,600. Anas ibn Malik, 2,286. And the fourth number was Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, 2,210. We also narrated how Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha came in the household of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After migration, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha remained for some time with her mother in a tribe. We had mentioned that. And thereafter, she came in the household, how the Ansar woman, they welcome her with poetry. And on that occasion, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala says, there was no camel cut, no goat or sheep. It was a very simple affair. But despite the simplicity of the affair, it was so blessed that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala had a very special relationship. Now when she comes in the household of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, let us understand certain aspects of the household of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had put up certain quarters next to the Masjid al-Nabawi. When Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam migrated from Makkah to Medina, the first thing Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam did, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam first constructed the Masjid. And this tells us the importance of the house of Almighty Allah, that before putting up his own home, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam first constructed the Masjid. The Masjid becomes the focal point of the community, the focal point of the spirituality, the community, and the communal aspects of the community were run from the Masjid in the time of Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Something that we really need to look at again in how Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam utilized the Masjid, and the Masjid became the focal point for the community's activities. Nevertheless, that was the focal point. Thereafter, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam put up apartments for his Hazrat Fatima radiallahu anha, the two wives of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time. And as other wives came, Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam added the apartment. The apartment was a very simple apartment. Subhanallah, sometimes it is absolutely amazing that the walls were of mud, no cement at that time, no fancy stones, no tiles, mud that became the walls of the house. And thereafter, the roof was from trunks of date palm. The date palm, the leaves, and the trunks became the roof. And because of the palms becoming the roof, sometimes water used to seep through. And because of that, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to put a blanket over the palms and trunks to be able to stop the seepage of water. And in this way, we know it was a very small room. We also know from traditions that when Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam sometimes used to perform salat, and when he wanted to make sijda, he used to make a noise, make an indication. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha used to fold her legs, and Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to make sijda. That was how small the room was. There was sometimes nothing cooked in the house of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for 2 moons. This was to show the length of time. Moons used to represent a calendar month. And one day Hazrat Urwa radiallahu ta'ala anha, Urwa bin Zubair, asked Hazrat Aisha, her auntie, her maternal aunt, "Oh my auntie, how did you people manage? If nothing was lit, no fire was lit, and there was nothing cooked in the house for 2 months, how did you people survive?" And that nothing cooked was not because of the fact that they could not cook, but it was because of the lack of resources. There was no wealth. There was a time of poverty. There was a time of difficulty. Yes, towards the end of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's time, there was greater accommodation. A little bit more wealth came in the hands of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. But initial stages, out of poverty. So Urwa ibn Zubair asked, "Oh my auntie, how did you people manage?" And she said that, "Oh my nephew, that for months we just survived on water and dates. And that used to be the way we used to survive. After all, they had a greater struggle, a greater striving. The striving was to propagate the message of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is no coincidence that how many years, 1400, 1500 years, that the deen has been preserved the way it was preserved and revealed upon Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam because of such sacrifices. Despite the fact that there was no fire, there was no lights that was lit in the house of Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam, yet it was a light and lamp of hidayat and guidance." So this way was the household. Despite the paucity of material things, despite the paucity of material aspects in the house, yet look at the relationship between Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Hazrat Aisha anha, a unique type of relationship. A relationship, and this is what we're going to spend today's program on. What was the relationship between Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Hazrat Aisha anha after the battle of Dhatus Salasil? Amr ibn al-As, who was made the leader of the expedition, and he was a newly reverted Muslim, comparative to the more senior and the more established companions like Abu Bakr and Umar. And of course, he came back feeling that perhaps he had got a very special relationship with Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. "Ya Rasulullah, who do you love most?" And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam replied, "Aisha." Subhanallah. I wonder if many people today would be asked that, "Who do you love or who do you like, or who do you like most? What will be our reply? And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Aisha, my wife. And thereafter, he asked amongst males, who do you like most and who do you love most? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, her father, Abu Bakr, the old companion of Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, about whom Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam had said, لو كنت متخذا غير ربي لاتخذت أبا بكر خليلا. If I would have made anyone a special friend besides Allah, but that special type of relationship of mine's is with my Creator. But if I had to make a special relationship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I would have made a special relationship with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala an, the father of Siddiqah, Siddiq, the father of Siddiqah, Abu Bakr, the father of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And once when the camel of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became rebellious, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha was on it, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam became very perturbed and disturbed. And he said, oh my bride, oh my bride, oh my wife. And on one occasion, that Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha came, and she came on behalf of the other wives of our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And they perhaps felt that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had a special attention towards Hazrat Fatima and towards Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. And they made Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala come to our beloved Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to come and speak about it and bring it to the attention of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have come to the time of the break. Inshallah, after the break, we will remember and we will speak about this aspect, that how did Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam respond to his daughter who came to on behalf of the other wives because of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's special relationship and his attachment to Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. Respected viewers, welcome back once again to our program. Before the break, we were speaking about Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's attachment to Hazrat Aisha, and because of which Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala anha, the beloved daughter of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, came to Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam on behalf of the other wife, saying in that perhaps Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's attachment was greater towards Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha compared to the other wives. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam heard. Now just bear this in mind, that as far as equality is concerned, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam spent every night with the different wives. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, after Asr, between the time of Asr and Maghrib, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to go and spend time with at each and every house, finding out about their welfare. Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam always gave every wife equal treatment in terms of what was within his control. Therefore, in one of dua, Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, oh Allah, that which is within my control, that I have done. But that which is not within my control, that, Ya Allah, do not hold me accountable. Our ulama say that when there is a person who has multiple spouses, as far as treatment, as far as time, as far as wealth is concerned, he's supposed to treat each and every one of them equally. However, emotions, feelings, love is something that is not within your control, that you will not be held accountable as long as it does not lead to injustice to the other spouses. And this was never in the case of our beloved Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala brought this. Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, oh Fatima, oh my daughter, would you not love someone whom your father loves? And Hazrat Fatima said, yes. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, love Aisha because I have great love for her. And Hazrat Fatima radiallahu ta'ala was again asked about it later on, and she said, no, my father had given me an answer and I'm going to remain content with that answer. Then later on, Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala, who was amongst the more senior wives of our beloved Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, a woman of great dignity, whom Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam relied upon her counsel and her advice many a times in his life. And we will come to it when we speak about Umm Salma, a remarkable woman, undoubtedly. And she also brought the same comment and the view from the other wives. And Nabi Kareem Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told Umm Salma, do not inconvenience me with regard to Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's love was not for other reasons other than her knowledge, her talent, her ability, able to grasp, and to be able to help the teachings of Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. As we had made mention, over 2,000 narrations, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala narrated from Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And of course, there were many other aspects that we will make mention of in terms of the relationship between Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala. One of them was that how Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala went beyond the norm. It was not only a relationship which was a normal husband-wife, but there were a lot of times in which they used to enjoy the company of one another. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala says, many a times Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to lie down upon my lap. How many times I used to comb the hair of Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and I used to comb the beard. And normally it happens when you love someone, then that particular love wants you to do something for your partner and your spouse. And this is what it used to happen. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala say, I used to comb the hair of Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, while sitting in a itikaf, used to lie down upon a pillar. And Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala used to apply hair oil upon our beloved Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam's hair. And one day, just show the relationship. One day Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam told Hazrat Aisha that, oh Aisha, I know when you are happy with me, and I know when you are sad with me. And Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, how do you know that, O Prophet of Almighty Allah? And Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, oh Aisha, when you are very happy with me, you are pleased with me, everything is going well, then normally you normally say that in your conversation, by the Lord of Muhammad. You take an oath and you take a qasam by the Lord of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when you are not so happy, when things are perhaps sometimes a lot of sometimes tension in the house, and the reason why there were these type of moments in the household of Nabi Karim sallallahu alaihi wasallam was to show the ummah that there are going to be times in marital life, in our household, where we do find these type of situations. Little tension between husband and wife. How do you deal with it? It's not as if the household of Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was free from tension. It was a household in which majority, overwhelming majority of the time, there was kindness, there was laughter, there was hospitality, there was relationship that was based on understanding and tolerance. But yet there were certain times which led to normal human emotions coming to the fore, which amounted to some form of tension. The Quran has made mention of it. And we will also, inshallah, speak about that. So Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that when you are happy with me, you take in your conversation by the Lord of Muhammad. When you are not so happy, you say by the Lord of Ibrahim. Subhanallah, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala laughed and said, Ya Rasulullah, that is only what I say with my tongue. But all the time, there is no doubt whatsoever that my love for you never ceases. It is always there. But Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also understood that. Look at understanding the temperament. I sometimes wonder how much in today's time do people know about their spouses? Do they know their favorite colors? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam knew this about his wife, that when she is happy, in a good mood, and not in a good mood. So when not in a good mood, obviously you deal with things slightly differently. You take into account those moods. Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam knew that. How much do we know with regard to our spouses in today's time? But there is also a sunnah of Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Because of her youngness, because of her being in her youth, Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also understood that and made special arrangements with regard to that. Therefore, you found that in the time of our beloved Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, that one day they were going out in a journey and Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam was alone with Aisha, and Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, oh Aisha, let us race. And they started racing. Aisha radiallahu ta'ala said, I was young, I was still small, I was very, very small at that time, I was thin, and because of that, I outraced, and I beat Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the latter years, one day we were alone in a journey again, or we were alone, and then Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, oh Aisha, let us race again, and they raced, and this time, Nabi Karim sallallahu alayhi wa sallam outpaced, outraced Hazrat Aisha, and then Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you know, in a humor said, this is for that last time. Last time you beat me, you outraced me, you outpaced me. This time I have outraced and I have outraced you. Look at this. Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam took into account. One day there was a display of the warriors in the courtyard of Masjid al-Nabawi. And Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala, because of her being young, she was enthusiastic. She wanted to see that. And Nabi Karim Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam allowed her. And how did he allow her? He made her stand over his shoulder. And he, the Prophet of the Almighty, As far as we believe, the greatest human being Allah Ta'ala has created, he stood there and waiting for his young wife to look over his shoulder, to look at the display of the warriors. He didn't move. He didn't show impatience. He waited until she had seen her fill. And when she had become tired, then only Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam moved from there. Subhanallah, what a relationship. On one occasion, there was an Ansari girl that because she did not have parents, she was an orphan. Then Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala in a way adopted and looked after her. And when the time came for her to get married, they got her married. At the time of the marriage, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam came, and so there was complete silence. And he said, "Oh Aisha, don't you know that the Ansar of Medina, they like a little bit of happiness at the time of marriage? What type of marriage is this? There is no happiness. There is no singing of poetry." And then Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala understood, and then the Ansaris got together and they started composing poetry. They started singing poetry. They took cans and they put stones and they started ringing those cans, which made a little bit of a noise. So this was how Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam related to Aisha. On the other hand, Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala was extremely fond and had greatest love to such an extent that sometimes that love overflowed even to the extent of perhaps becoming into a sense possessiveness and sensitive, being very sensitive of Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And let me just give you one or two remarkable incidents. One day she got up and she saw Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam was not around. Feeling that perhaps Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam had gone to the other wives, she started went out in search of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And she saw Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, on one occasion she saw Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam making salat and praying to Almighty Allah. And she felt regretful. And she said, "What am I thinking? And what is the Nabi of Allah doing? I'm thinking that he had gone to the other wives. And in reality, he had not gone. He had actually gone to worship Allah. He was praying before Almighty Allah." One day, Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam had gone. Hazrat Aisha pursued, "Where is he gone? Perhaps he had gone to the other wives." So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and he was at the Qabristan, at the Qabr, and he was praying for the deceased. And she hurried back. Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam did see her coming back. And when he came back, he saw that she was short of breath. And he said, "Oh Aisha, why did you do that?" And she said an amazing thing. It was either at that time or another occasion when she showed sensitivity and possessiveness. She said an amazing thing. She said, "Why should a person like me not be sensitive about a person like you? Why should a person... And why should a wife like me who has so much love and concern for you not be sensitive and possessive over a person like you?" On one occasion, when she was, you know, on one occasion there was this whole incident where Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was resting on her lap. And Hazrat Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu had become angry with her and for a certain reason. And I will make mention of it as we go and speak about the other virtues. And because Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam was on her lap, Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu was angry with her. Because of her delaying the army had delayed, it was a time of Salat, there was no water available, and now there was a chance that people were going to come at the time of Salat, no water to perform ablution, to perform the prayers. And everyone was saying, "Aisha had delayed the army, therefore this has happened." And Nabi Hazrat Abu Bakr came, and Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala started poking her on different parts of her body, and she said, "I remained silent, I couldn't protect myself, because I didn't want to inconvenience the Nabi of Allah who was sleeping on my lap." And thereafter, when he went away and when he got up, he realized the situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verses containing and speaking about tayammum, that if there is no water, then use mud to be able to perform the ablution and perform your prayers. Abu Bakr came back and said, "Oh my daughter, I am regretful over what I have done. How merciful, how blessed you are because of that. You have brought accommodation that in the absence of water, people can perform ablution with sand, by just using sand and wiping it over their body to be able to pray in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." This was a relationship that characterized how Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam and Hazrat Aisha radiallahu ta'ala used to be. May Allah ta'ala give us the tawfiq of really understanding this unique type of relationship, and let we be inspired that our relationships also be in a similar manner. وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين.
دعوني أناجي مولا جليلا إذا الليل أرخى علي السدولا نظرت إليك بقلب ذليل لأرجو به يا إلهي قبولا.